The newly married Mozart led a lively social life and didn't skimp on entertainment, food, or drink. From the days of his youth, when the food he most fancied was liver dumplings and sauerkraut, Mozart's tastes in food had undergone considerable sophistication, and visitors to the couple's apartment were likely to be offered such fare as roast pheasant, a variety of rare meats, oysters, glacé fruits, and a range of fine wines, including Moselle and Champagne. In January of 1783, to celebrate the new year and Constanze's first pregnancy, the Mozarts held a ball in their own spacious quarters, which lasted from 6 p.m. till 7 o'clock the following morning. From the beginning, they lived beyond their means. The continuous, lavish gifts from royalty in Mozart's childhood and early teens had left him with expensive tastes, and whatever their financial circumstances in later life, he had an almost compulsive love of the finest clothing. When Muzio Clementi first saw him on the occasion of their pianistic duel, he mistook him for a senior chamberlain or a court official. But Mozart developed his own special means of acquiring it. Take this note to one of his Viennese patrons, the Baroness Waldstetten.
Dearest Baroness, about that beautiful red coat which attracted me so, please, please let me know where it is to be had and how much it costs. I was so enchanted by its splendour that I failed to register its price. I simply have to have one like it, for it will do perfect justice to certain buttons which I have long coveted. I saw them once while choosing some for a suit. They were in the button factory in the coal market. They are mother of pearl, with a few white stones round the edge, and an exquisite yellow stone in the centre. I like all of my things to be of good quality, genuine and beautiful. Why is it, I wonder, that people who could never afford it would like to spend a fortune on such articles, and those who can do not do so?
And the ploy worked as it usually did. But, also as usual, the lady was paid handsomely, far more than the coat could conceivably have cost, in the one currency which Mozart always had in abundance.
Dearest, best, and loveliest of all, gilt, silvered, and sugared, most valued and honoured, gracious Lady Baroness. Herewith I have the honour to send your ladyship, in gratitude for having at once taken so much trouble about the beautiful coat, and for your goodness in finding one just like it, 2 volumes of plays, a little book of stories, and most particularly, the rondo of which we spoke.